Hello everyone, good morning to all of you. Today in this video we are going to discuss numericals based on Miller indices and reciprocalities. If you see the previous videos, I think 5-6 videos, those videos are based on Miller indices and reciprocalities, in which we discussed about theory part. Okay, so today on the basis of those topics or those theories, we are going to see how much we have learned, and that is why in this video I have collected 5-6 numericals, and these numericals are very important for your coming examinations, especially for part 3 students. So let us see the numericals one by one. The first numerical is lattice constant of cube lattice is A. This is the lattice constant. Calculate the spacing. Here first 2-1-1 plane, and second this one 1-0-1 plane. So we have given two planes, and what we are going to do, or what we have to do, we have to calculate the spacing. If you recall the previous video, you will find that in a lattice there are large number of planes having large number of orientations, and the planes which are parallel to each other, there is a gap, and the gap or the distance between the two planes is called spacing, or you may say interplanar distance. Which formula is this one? Already we have discussed in the previous video. D is the interplanar spacing. D is equal to A by H square K square plus L square root. That is power half. What is A? A is the cube lattice. And edge, you may say, you know that in a cube there are three edges, A, B, C, and all are equal. So here you may take HKL. What is HKL? Already you know these are the three integers representing a plane. So on putting the values from the numericals, see here, first for 2-1-1 plane, 2 means H, 1 that is K, 1 that is L. So HKL. Now see here, D is equal to A. A is given here. A is A. Its value is not given. It is in letter form. So A is here, and it is 2 square, 1 square, 1 square. So how much? 2 square means 4. 1 square means 1. 1 square means 1. 4 plus 1 plus 1, that is 6 to the power half, means root 6. So this is your answer. So very easy. You have to use only formula, and once you know the formula and what are the symbols for what it is, they stand, then you can put the value. So similarly, you can solve this one, 1-0-1 planes. Again, I want to say that 1-H-0-K-1 L. So HKL 101, and lattice constant is A. So again D is equal to A by this one, and A by 1 square 1 1 square 1. So 1 plus 1 2, 2 to the power half means root 2. So A by root 2. So this is your answer. Okay, I hope you have understood this problem. You have to remember this formula. Now second question is based on Miller indices. This question demands find the Miller indices. You can see here, find the Miller indices. To get the Miller indices, what we should know? We should know three intercepts, and these are given. So I am reading the problem. For the intercepts x, y, z with values 3, 1, 2, means along x-axis, or you may say on the x-axis, the intercept is 3. On the y-axis, intercept is 1. On the z-axis, intercept is 2. So first, in the first step, we write intercept length, that is 3, 1, 2. Now, we get the reciprocal of these intercept length. So it is 1 by 3, 1 by 1, 1 by 2. Whole numbers. Means we simplify this. To simplify this, what we do? We take the LCM here. LCD, least common division. So 3, 1, 2, that is 6. So that is why we multiply each one by 6. 6 into 1 by 3, 6 into 1 by 1, 6 into 1 by 2. These are 2, 6 and 3. And we write in round bracket 2, 6, 3. And this is the way to write the answer, 2, 6. So its answer, you may say Miller indices are 2, 6, 3. Now you can, if you have not learned, if you are not able to learn here, you can see another problem. And I think it will be clear. See here. Again, we see the intercept. What are the intercept? First, we read the problem. Find the Miller indices. So question is same. Here, find the Miller indices. Here, find the Miller indices. So purpose is same. And here intercepts were 3, 1, 2. Here intercepts are 2a minus 3b, 4c. We proceed in the same fashion, similar way. So first step, we take intercept length. So what is its intercept length? On the x-axis 2, on the y-axis minus 3, on the z-axis 4. So I write here 2 minus 3, 4. Okay. This step is clear. Now second step. In second step, we take the reciprocal. Simply we invert this. 1 by 2, 1 by minus 3, 1 by 4. Okay. The least common denominator is 12. As I told you earlier in the above problem, in the previous problem, that to get the simplified form, we take the least common denominator of 2, minus 3 and 4. That is 12, and that is why we multiply each one by 12. 12 into 1 by 2, that is 6, this one. 12 into minus 1 by 3, that is minus 4. 12 into 1 by 4, 3. And we write all the 3 digits in a round bracket. So 6, 4 bar, 3. Here 4 bar, this is important. If you don't know, I try to clear it. 4 bar means along negative axis. That is minus 4. It is a tradition that we write 4 and 1 bar notation above the digit. So 6, 4 bar, 3. We read like this. Okay. I hope you have understood this problem. Now I am coming to the problem number 4. What is the problem number 4? The spacing between successive 100 plans. This is the plan. In NaCl, sodium chloride is 2.8 angstrom degree. Spacing, as I told you earlier, spacing means distance between two parallel planes. Interplanar spacing, you may say. So it is 2.82 angstrom degree, which is denoted by D. Here you may write A also. So see here, d is equal to a is equal to this one. Now I proceed. X ray incident on the surface of the crystal is found to give rise to first order. If you see here, first order means n is equal to 1. Second order means n is equal to 2. Since here first order, so I write here n is equal to 1, this one. Okay. Breaks reflection at glancing angle 8.8 degree. Actually, glancing angle is denoted by theta. So this one is theta. Theta is equal to 8.8 degree. Calculate the wavelength. So lambda is equal to what? Now you can see these three things are given. First, interplanar spacing is given. Second, first order, for first order means n is given. And third, glancing angle is given, that is theta is given. Okay, and our purpose, requirement to calculate the wavelength, that is why I have written here lambda is equal to what. Since this question is related to Bragg's X-ray diffraction, second or third video, I think, is related with Bragg's X-ray diffraction. So in that video, you can see the result. According to Bragg's law, 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. This formula has been proved already. Okay. So here d is given, theta is given, n is given. I have to know lambda, and from this formula, lambda is equal to 2d sin theta by n. I have used this formula, lambda is equal to, and we put the values which are given, 2 into, see here, this is actually interplanar spacing was given in angstrom degree, and we use SI unit, that is why we have to convert angstrom degree into meter. And as you know, 1 angstrom degree is equal to 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So 2.82 angstrom degree means 2.82 into 10 to the minus 10 meter, and this one is sine 8.8. Here you may feel problem because this is not a common angle, it is not 30 degree, 0 degree, 90 degree, which you remember usually. But if table is given, if table is provided, trigonometrical table, in that table you will go to the sine angle, and in that table you will find the value sine 8.8 degree is equal to 0.153. If table will not be supplied in the examination, then this value will be given in the question paper. So don't worry, need not to be worried. You will get either supplied value or you have to contact with the table, and this value you have to read from the table. So sine 8.8 degree is equal to 0.153, and if this value is taken here, on solving we get this one. You will multiply because there is no need of divide from one because it will be same. So and here 10 to the power minus 10, again you may convert it into angstrom degree. Okay, so this is your answer. Now come to the next problem, problem number 5. So that reciprocal lattice to SC direct space lattice, SC here simple cubic, is itself a simple cubic lattice, means we have to prove that simple cubic lattice of a direct simple, in a simple cubic direct space lattice is itself a simple cubic in reciprocal. So go to the reciprocal lattice video where you will see the what is reciprocal lattice, how to construct reciprocal lattice, and what are the primitive translation vectors. So all these things are already given, and we have discussed already so need not to be discussed here. Okay, now we are going to solve this problem. We can write the vectors as A is equal to AX. Here X is the unit vector along X axis. Y is the unit vector along, X is the unit vector X cap along X axis. Y is the unit vector along Y axis. And Z is the unit vector along Z axis. And primitive translation vectors are written as A, B and C. Here A is common. A because it is a cube. Taking the vectors A, B and C, each of magnitude A, as I stated just now, along the coordinate axis X, Y and Z, X cap, Y cap and Z cap being unit vectors in those directions respectively. Already I have mentioned this. Now the formula, the volume of the cubic cell. Okay. The volume of the cubic cell V is equal to A dot B cross C or B dot A cross C, C cross A or C dot A cross B. And when solved, since A, B, C all are equal, so we may write A cube. Okay. Now, these are the primitive translation vector of direct relative. And now we are going to calculate the primitive translation vectors for reciprocal lattice. And as we have seen, as you saw in earlier video, that it is, these are the symbols A star vector, B star vector or C star vector. These are the primitive translation vector for reciprocal lattice. And this is the formula. Here B cross C. What is B? AY. What is C? AZ. So AY cap, AZ cap. On solving, and if you divide, it is A square, it is A cube. So A square by A cube. What is A cube? A cube is the volume. Okay, you can come here. A cube. Okay, so A square by A cube means A here, 1 by A and 2 pi by A x cap. Y cross Z means x cap. Similarly, we get B and C. So here, A star is equal to this one, B star is vector is equal to this one, C. And these are the value of A, B, C. So we can say that in reciprocal lattice, simple cubic direct lattice itself is simple cubic lattice with lattice constant 2 pi by A. 2 pi by A here, 2 pi by A here, 2 pi by A here. Okay. Now we will discuss the last problem of this video. What is the problem? First, I read the problem. X-ray of 1.5 angstrom. Angstrom. Whenever you say angstrom, at once comes in your mind, it is the wavelength. Okay. So wavelength is equal to this one. We convert it into meter by multiplying by 10 to the power minus 10. Glancing angle. This one is glancing angle. As I told you a few minutes before, glancing angle is denoted by 16 degree. In first order, again first order means n is equal to 1, this one. Then what is required? Find the lattice constant. Lattice constant, as I told you earlier, that it lattice constant denoted by either A or D. I have written here D. And recall the formula, Bragg's law. This type of numerical you have solved earlier. So you will write 2D sin theta is equal to what? N lambda. Here I want to get D. So 2 sin theta is taken this side. And that is why I write N lambda. This D will not be here. By mistake, this D is here, so correct this. Okay, I hope you have understood. This D has come by the mistake, printing mistake. So it is D is equal to n lambda by 2 sine theta here. N is equal to what? 1. Lambda is equal to this one, and 2 is equal to 2 is digit, and sine theta is equal to sine 60 degree. Again, sine 60 degree is this one. Need not to remember. It will be supplied, or table will be supplied. You will contact the table and you can get the value. I think most probably this value will be supplied. On solving, we get 2.72 into 10 to the power minus 10. This is in meter, we convert it in angstrom. So I have collected here 6 problems for you. Okay, and if you solve these 6 problems, on the basis of these 6 problems, you may solve another problems also, and these problems will help you to solve other problems in the coming examination. So I hope you have understood this video. Thank you.